Hello guys, today we are going to learn about variables and constants in C++ for beginners. Okay, many of you have habit of writing notes while watching lectures in YouTube or some other way. So, here we came up with new solution where we don't need to write any notes and you can directly access to our digital notes in our blog. So, you can type code with dev.blogspot.com in browser. And enter. Now you can be directed to our website where you can select lectures from our menu and previously completed how to start coding. And now we came to variables and constants in C++. Please click on it. Here is the notes required for this lecture. You can go through it anytime freely. It is completely free for every student. You can go and access and read everything. Here each and every word is explained. Since it is a second lecture, you might confused about different words in here. So, but don't give up guys. You can continue reading and go on learning coding. Currently, our main aim is to learn about variables and constants. So, please don't get panicked if you found new keywords or new words, new terminology. You are going to learn everything in our future lectures. Currently, concentrate on our new topic. Variables and C++. Variables and constants in C++. Yeah. What are variables? Variables are important basic elements in coding. They are used to store values like numbers, alphabets, sentences, etc. For example, we can compare variables like containers like you can see here. If you think this is the variable, it can store some values like 2 and this can be stored 3. We can also store another these are integers till now we store. We can also store characters like A, and we can store another character like plus, and we can store another character we can also store decimal numbers like 3.12. So variables are like a container which can store values, type of integers, and float values like float values or decimal numbers or characters. Now we can move on to constants. What are constants? Constants are like a container which can have closed lid. See, if you place one inside and we close that lid, see here. So one is closed. Now we cannot take that one and replace it with another. So constants means, if you can understand that, it maintains a constant value. We can't replace it, the value inside it. If we assign a character, another number 23 into a constant, it is stored in the container and closed by the lid. So we cannot take it out and we cannot replace it. Here in this variable, we can take this A and assign another character, you can see here. I am removing this A from this container, and now we can add B to this container. So variables can be varied. So we can change the values inside the variable. What is this int? Many of you might confuse about what is int, what is char, what is float, and what is some other. You might know in future. Int is a type of container. It only stores integers. This green container only stores integers like 1 or 2 or 3. And character is another type of container like this yellow container. It only stores character types like alphabets A or B or C or capital A or character like plus, minus, or dollar, etc. Also, what is a float? A float is nothing but it is another type of container. It only stores variables like, values like 2.12 or 2.20. It will store decimal values. Thus, we can say this integer and about integer character float. Similarly, variables can be taken from the container, like they can vary, and constants cannot be taken from the container. Thus, we can say about variables and constants. Where these usable variables are used? These variables are used everywhere in coding, like solving arithmetic expressions. Like we can say, wait a second. Delete code. Here, int a is equal to 20. See guys, here we are assigning 20 to a variable a. And int b is equal to 22. Finally, we will get int c is equal to a plus b. Finally, we get answer as 42 output. Thus, variables are used to add two numbers like a and b. Also, we can multiply, division. I will show them in compiler. Why these are called variables? You can understand that why these are called as variables, because they can be changed. The values stored in them can be changed. What are constants? Here you can see const int. So a is equal to 20. Here you can see we added a const in front of int a. This here you can see it is a variable. Here we write int. Int defines what type of value a can store. Like a can store 20 or 20.2. If we write float here, then a will store float values like 20.0, 20.1. So here we can change variable a. So we can write here like a is equal to 2. Here we can change. We should not again keep this in. We only write int first time to say what type of variable it is. Here we write an a is equal to 2. So means we change the value of a from 20 to 2. Here we try this. As you see, a is a const. We added a new keyword const. It says that a is not a variable and a is a constant. So if we write a is equal to for some purpose, we will say this is cancel this. To avoid confusion, let's say this is int b. Wait a second. Not int b. Let's say this is some constant z. Int z is equal to 20. Now we cannot say z is equal to 5 or some other, because already we assigned said that z is a constant. It cannot be changed. Here a can be changed because it is variable. Here z cannot be changed because it is a constant. Now I think you got to some basic idea about variables and functions. Yeah. You can say here int is used to decide what type of value is stored in this year. Here const is used to say whether it is a constant or variable. What this A, B, C are called in terminology, coding terminology. Guys, these A, B, and Z, these are all called identifiers. We can create identifiers which can store values like 20, characters like plus and minus, and also float like 20.12. So, identifier can have capability to store the values. Okay, now I will introduce